Baseball on the show from the bank, Citizens Bank Park in Philadelphia. Today we've got a contest out of the National League East between the Miami Marlins and the Philadelphia Phillies. It's Baseball on the Show, and it's coming up next. Zach Wheeler gets the ball for Philadelphia in this one. Dan Plesac, what's the word on it?
Hey, Matty D, we're getting a chance to look at a guy that's been, like, white hot. How about a whip under 1.00 in his last three starts? Not a lot of base runners, and that usually adds up to a lot of success. Let's see if he can continue to do that in this one here today.
Here's Starling Marte, and we are ready for some daytime baseball.
Starling Marte.
First delivery to him. Underway now in the Sunday finale as the first pitch today is taken for strike one. Dan Dero, these Phillies, as they begin play here today, they've been playing some pretty good baseball of late as they've won six of their last eight games.
Hey, thanks, Matty. Hey, you know what, Dero? Try to get on a kind of a little mini winning streak here. Losing the first game of this series, winning game two, and hopefully winning this series by pulling one out here today.
Yeah, Dan, they were able to shower that first loss off in the first game of this series and had a nice bounce back game yesterday. Let's see if they can steal the series right here.
A ball and two strikes now. Very nice afternoon, high skies, and 77 degrees at game time. Swung on, and this ball is hammered. Forget about it. And out of here, and I mean by plenty. That ball was crushed. It's a solo shot for Starling Marte. 12 home runs for him now thus far, as the Marlins will take a 1-0 lead.
Well, this has started off certainly quick. First batter of the game goes deep. Dare I say, ambush tactics?
So now to the plate, John Birdie. As he will look at a first pitch fastball for ball one. His career line against Wheeler, just 3-for-14. He's also gone down on strikes five times. Base is empty here with nobody out. Runs outside, so it goes to 2-0 now. Wheeler has registered just under 110 innings on the mound. And over those innings, he's worked to a whip of just a little over 1.3, so he's a reliable arm in terms of limiting traffic on the base paths. Line towards center field. That gets down, and he's got himself a base hit.
This is the cat and mouse of baseball right here. Batter versus pitcher. You fight so hard as an offensive player to get count leverage. 1-0, 2-0, 3-1. Check out the batting averages in those counts. And then check out the batting averages in even and behind counts with two strikes. 2-0, your eyes light up, and that batter didn't miss it.
Into the box, Corey Dickerson pitches high. The throw is right on the money, and Real Muto got him.
Wow, that's a big-time throw right there. And it's a tall task to throw him out stealing a bag. But he got rid of it quickly, and it was a good job down there applying the quick tag. They'll have to feel good about that.
And that one yanked just foul. The 1-1. Pops this one up. Boom. Shading to his right. He's got it, and there are two down now.
That is it. The first baseman.
So next to hit is Jesus Aguilar. He went hitless last night in a game where his guys could push across only one score. First offering on its way.
Hey, they say solos won't kill us, but I gotta believe this guy's looking to do exactly that.
That one's going to find the seats. Strike one. Two out, nobody on. Now a good pitch around the knees, but it doesn't quite catch the bottom of the zone. He's fallen behind now, 3-1. Miguel Rojas would be next. The 3-1. Finds the zone to fill the count, 3-2.
Hey, I still believe in my heart the best pitch is a well-executed fastball down and away, and that's exactly what that is. He swings at that. That's off the end of the bat. That's not hard contact at all, and that's an easy out for the defense. That's the game plan right there. Elevate the sinker from the offensive standpoint. That's what they talked about in the hitters meeting. And on the flip side, if the pitcher doesn't get that pitch down, there's going to be a call to the pen shortly.
At the plate now, Miguel Rojas.
Nope, at the ball.
As he'll take a look at ball one. His career line against Wheeler comes in with 6 hits in 23 at-bats. And of those hits, 3 of them were of the home run variety. Hard on the ground towards short. Segura fields it cleanly. And he'll go the short way to retire the side. One for the Marlins on the solo shot. Home half of the first on its way from Citizens Bank Park. Miami out to an early 1-0 lead. Eliezer Hernandez gets the starting assignment for the Fish in this matchup. What do you have for us on him, Danny?
Hey, you can't always judge a pitcher by the numbers. I know the ERA is into the fours coming into this start, but he's actually a pretty solid pitcher. And every once in a while, he can throw some decent games in there. It's not easy having an ERA under 4 in baseball. He's slightly over that, but this guy's a better pitcher than that ERA indicates.
But an Adam ball right to him for the first down.
Batting second, the third baseman, Alec Bohm.
That brings up Alec Bohm. Ready to deal. Here comes the first pitch. Just a bit high with the fastball, but didn't get the call. These Marlins, as they take the field this afternoon, it was another loss for them last time out, and that makes them 2-8 over their last 10 games.
Yeah, Matty, this is the big one right here. They split the first 2 games of this series. You want to steal one right here and be feeling good about yourself.
Yeah, Dero, I think one of the things you want to do, you get to the third game, you'd like to win this series and finish it off by winning game 3. It's always nice to win a series, whether it's at home or on the road. So this is a big one for this ball club.
One and two now. One out, nobody on. And a fastball blew it right by him, and there are 2 down.
This is why it's so hard to be successful as a hitter when you fall behind in the count. One and two, you're probably expecting some sort of off-speed pitches, but when the pitcher offers up a good, hard fastball, it's pretty hard to adjust and catch up to it.
Here's Bryce Harper now. He'll go after the first pitch and bounce it into foul territory. He'll start this one at 274. 17 home runs and 60 runs batted in. And a pitch in the dirt as he lays off. It's 1-1. In his career against this pitcher, he's gone 5-for-13. He's also hit a couple of home runs against him. And he takes one off the inside corner for ball 2.
Pretty good pitch right here to a left-handed power hitter. The one thing you want to do, keep the ball inside so he can't get those long arms out and extended. Really good pitcher's pitch right there, even though he didn't get the called strike.
Bouncer to the left side. reined in. Throw over to Aguilar at first. He'll take care of him to end the inning. Three up, three down for Philadelphia. They're on the short end of a 1-0 score. Jacob Stallings will be the next hitter. He'll lead things off here in this one-run contest. First pitch of the AB now. Lifted in the air to center field. Hazley is there. One pitch, one out.
Batting seven, the third baseman, Ryan Anderson.
So bases are empty with one gone, and that'll bring up the outfielder, Brian Anderson. First pitch on its way.
At the ball.
Ball one. Bases are empty, one man out. And he'll lay off here as well, and it's 2-0 to the Miami third sacker. Three and oh now. And there's a strike as he'll try to work his way back. It's 3-1. Full count now. 3-2 pitch. Making him sweat out there. The seventh pitch coming up. Lifted in the air toward the line and right. And a great diving effort there, but it'll just tip off his glove, and it's a base hit.
I know this guy isn't known for his hitting prowess, but that's a nice job right there. Getting a single on a 3-2 pitch in the middle of the zone. Grab your glove and flash some leather.
To the plate now, Connor Scott. Runners on the move for second. Popped him up. And he'll get over to it kicks off his glove. How did he do that? A ball and strike. And set up behind the plate is Joe McDonald, as you see the rest of our umpiring crew in this one.
You know, you got to take your time and feel Joe McDonald out behind the dish a little bit. He has a tendency to move his zone around, usually settling in those middle innings.
You know, all you ask for an umpire is to be consistent. At times, Joe Mack is a little bit too inconsistent, particularly from a pitcher standpoint.
Ball taken there. 2-1 now. Has a look. Now the pitch. 2-2.
Ready to count. 2-2.
Anderson leads off first with one away. Oh, and he can't catch up to the fastball as he swings and misses for the second out. Got him with a good high fastball there. Danny, we see a lot of that pitch in strikeout situations these days. What makes it so effective?
I think, Matt, what makes it such a tough pitch is you're changing eye levels. That fastball up looks so enticing to hit that you think you see that ball as a hitter. You think you can drive it, but it's really hard to get on top of that good high hard fastball.
Standing in now, Eliezer Hernandez. As he takes a cold strike at the knees, it's 0-1. From the belt, the pitch. And this pitch is popped straight up, right around the home plate area. Real Muto's there, and that'll end the inning. Marlins leave one, and after an inning and a half, it's 1-0. bottom of the inning now. And next to bat will be the first baseman, Reese Hoskins.
The first baseman, Reese Hoskins.
And the pitch.
He'll take that first pitch strike all day long. If they're going to take 0-0, he's going to pound that zone and get ahead. Much more susceptible down 0-1 than 1-0.
One ball and one strike to the Phillies first baseman. And well, this ball runs away for ball two. 2-1.
I don't blame him for not coming over the heart of the plate. He circled this guy on the lineup card when he got to the yard today. He's been swinging one of the hotter bats in the game.
The 2-1 home.
That's a good take on a fastball out of the zone. Hey, I get it. He's looking for a ball to drive, but that ball was a little bit too far up in the zone. That's one you normally pop right up.
Gets him to swing and miss there. 3-2.
Hey, this pitcher better be careful right here. My man at the plate is not trying to push something to the opposite field.
Did well just to make contact there as he spoils off a good changeup. Another full count pitch home. On the ground and right at the shifted infielders. And there's one away.
Batting fifth, the catcher, JT Realmuto.
And now here is JT Realmuto, lifetime against this pitcher. Just a 2-for-14 line, so advantage pitcher here. He's taken him deep once. And now the first pitch.
Oh, that's off the plate.
Hit in the air down the left field line. Dickerson's after it, and that's in there. Base hit. And this will find the wall deep in the corner, and he'll reach second now with one away.
When it left his bat, I thought it might squirt foul, but it hugged the line and found its way into the corner. Thought it might be a little bit closer play at second, but he cruised in there with relative ease.
So the next hitter to dig in will be Andrew McCutchen. As the first pitch misses to him, it's ball one. One out and a runner on second base. Two balls and no strikes.
Hey, you want to talk about being in a zone? This guy's been raking lately, and it all starts with his pitch selection. Two great takes, and he's almost daring the pitcher. Just go ahead and challenge him.
Fouled off. The 2-1 home is offered at and missed. He chased it for strike two. There's ball three on a breaking ball that misses away.
Going to need to make a little bit of an adjustment with a slider release and at least tempt the hitter that it's going to be a strike.
Now the payoff pitch home is a wave and a miss. He struck him out.
Boy, that's the best pitch in baseball right there with two strikes. That elevated fastball. That every tough hitter thinks that, hey, they can do something with that. But most of the time, you get the result you saw right there. A big swing and a miss and another strikeout.
Here's Didi Gregorius as he'll try to hold back on the swing, but he went around for the first strike. Runner in scoring position with two gone. The 0-1 offering. A swing and a ground ball to third. Throw over to Aguilar at first will take care of him to end the inning. One hit, one left. Play two full. It's the Marlins one and the Phillies nothing. back with Mark DeRosa and Dan Plesac. Matt Vasgersian as Starling Marte steps in to start out the inning. Now the first pitch. Starling Marte is at the plate as he watches ball one. Two balls, no strikes to the Miami center fielder.
I wonder if that homer rattled him a little bit. He's certainly a little bit more cautious against him this time around.
On, he pops it up. Hoskins into foul territory, and no one can get there. It's a foul ball. Sent foul again, and after being way ahead, now it's even at 2-2. Into the windup and the pitch.
Full count, 3-2.
Well, you don't see it all that often, but this might be a good time for a 3-2 change. If he can locate it, it's nearly impossible to hit.
Count remains full. Once again, a 3-2. And he lays off there, ball four. So the leadoff man is on here to begin inning number three.
And that's what you want from your leadoff hitter. Show some great patience and discipline, making the pitcher labor to start the game. The result is a leadoff walk and a chance to make some early noise.
In now, John Birdie, as he will take strike one on the fastball here. No balls and a strike. One for one with a single so far. Marte off for second. Pitch inside. The throw is going to be far too late. That's a stolen base.
Good steal there, and I'll tell you, he is a multi-dimensional player out there. He's got good pop at the plate, and he showed he's not afraid to use his wheels on the bases either.
To your point, Dan, he did go deep earlier, and now the stolen base here, so he's really having an impact on this game. Now the 1-1 pitch. Timing just to tick off there as this one's fouled off to the right.
It's going to be back to some serious tee work if he can't put that pitch in play right in his wheelhouse.
Fastball swung on and missed for the first out.
This is where a strikeout pitcher has such a big advantage. Runner on second and no outs is definitely a strikeout situation in order to keep that runner from getting to third with less than two outs. When you can do it, it changes the whole strategy of the inning. Even a ground ball to the right side makes this a lot more dangerous situation.
So now to the plate, Corey Dickerson, as he will take a look at strike one on a fastball right down the pipe. 0 for 1 after a pop out in foul territory his first time through. On its way, the 0-1 pitch. Way inside with that one, a pretty easy take there. Marte, the runner at second with one away. And the runner's breaking for third. Pitches high. The throw is in time as he gets the tag down, and he's out trying to take third.
I noticed he had a big lead there at second, so I wasn't surprised when he took off, but that lead didn't pay off as he still gets caught trying to swipe third.
The 2-1. Him up. Segura in foul ground, and that will end the inning. Nothing doing for the Marlins. They lead it 1-0. So coming to the plate, Adam Haseley, arguably one of the hotter hitters in the league right now.
Adam.
delivery to him. Called a strike on the outer half. 0-1. Lifetime against this particular arm. He's 1-for-4. A high fastball is in there.
I get it. He wants to see this guy's repertoire, but now he's behind in the count. Puts himself in a tough spot to hit.
Good job to spoil that one away, and he stays alive. The windup and the 0-2 pitch. And on 0-2, he misses with a fastball.
Count 1-2.
High in the air down the right field line. Scott is over to his left as he snags this one for the first out of the inning. So now into the box is Zach Wheeler. Now the first pitch.
Nope. Ball one.
One out, nobody on. Hit on the ground down the first baseline. And he'll take it to the bag himself for the out. Two down, no one on base. And that'll bring in Jin Segura. Here's the first pitch to him. Hit hard toward the right side. That gets down, and the inning will continue. Running hard, he's digging for second. And now he'll get into scoring position with two away. And this, of course, is a ballpark that yields a lot of doubles. As we take a look at the team leaders for the most two base hits this year. And we see there that they're currently ranked third best in that category in the NL. And now in the box, Alec Bohm trying here to plate the tying run from second. First delivery to him. Ready with the 1-0.
That's a ball.
Tough situation for him right here. I mean, he's got an open base, so he doesn't have to give in to this guy. But there's definitely danger looming on deck, so you can't just completely work around him either.
2-1 after the foul ball there. The set and the 2-1. 2-2.
Wow, what makes it so tough to be a hitter is to be able to hit and change his speeds, right? You're geared up for the fastball, and all of a sudden, he pulls the string and throws you the straight change, the dreaded equalizer.
Skied in the air to straightaway left. Dickerson's there. No problem with this one, and the inning is over. Two-out double, left stranded. We're back with more on a Sunday afternoon following this. And we're back from Citizens Bank Park in Philadelphia. Let's check in with Heidi Watney.
Matt, during the commercial break, I had a chance to catch up with manager Don Mattingly about the Marlins' offensive production.
And flat out, he was very pleased with the quality of their at-bats.
Yes, they've only scored one run, but he said they've done a great job of forcing the pitch count up, and he thinks that's going to lead to more offense for them as this game goes on.
Okay, thank you, Heidi. Into the box, Jesus Aguilar. He singled in his first AB.
Yeah, guys, everyone knows he's been slumping. Dan, you can certainly attest to this, only amassing a solid one hit in your entire career. The pressure's off now. Maybe he gets hot.
First pitch of the AB on its way. Aguilar tends to have more success against right-handed pitching like this than he does against southpaws. Could be a comfort thing. Maybe he just picks up the ball a little better, but that's the book on him at this point. To the left side, but it's well fouled. The windup and the 0-2 pitch. Sinker misses, and it's 1-2 now.
This guy's been really on point so far, but it's not getting any easier. He has to get through 4, 5, and 6 right here.
And that misses 2-2.
We just saw a fastball right there. I would not be shocked if he tries to get this guy to go fishing right here and drops a little off-speed pitch in the dirt.
A little tardy on that swing as it's well wide of first.
Hey, usually the second time through the order, you start seeing an incorporation of some more off-speed stuff. But this guy's locating, feeling really good about his fastball. Two back-to-back.
Another one sent foul.
Put that in the memory bank. First time he breaks out a curveball right there, and it's a pretty good one.
Grounded back up the middle. Throw to first in time. One gone here in the fourth. So now here is Miguel Rojas. And now the first pitch. Into the windup, here comes the 0-1. Oh, and a look what I found out there on the mound. And he'll just flip this on to first for the second out of the inning. Stepping in next, Jacob Stallings flew out last time up. Here's the first pitch. Fastball just misses. That's ball one. Ball and a strike.
Hey, I don't blame him for giving up on that curveball. That was a rainbow coming out of the sky. Stole a strike.
One and two. I think it's safe to say he wasn't ready for the fastball.
Wow, was he behind that fastball? Great job on the mound using the curveball to set up the heater.
And they could go either way now, I suppose.
No touchdown.
Here's another 1-2. And the inning goes away in unceremonious fashion on a swing and a miss at a ball way outside the strike zone. 1-2-3 go the Marlins, but they hold a 1-0 lead. And Bryce Harper will dig into the plate.
The right fielder.
Outfield shaded toward right center. Here's the first pitch.
1-0.
And a fastball misses here to start the at bat. It's 1-0. That's inside. 2-0.
Pitching isn't always about getting everyone out. Sometimes it's about being smart and knowing when to pick your battles. He's been really careful with this hitter so far, and rightfully so.
And he fouls this one off. Line to shortstop, and there's one away. So one down, no one aboard. And that'll bring in a perennial MVP candidate for years to come, Rhys Hoskins. First pitch on its way. A windup and the 0-1. And a changeup here, but that's taken low in the dirt for a ball. And he lays off upstairs, but it's ruled a strike, and he can't believe it. 1-2. And the slider gets him swinging. Two gone. Good job of making him chase a pitch for the strikeout there.
Yeah, Matt, that's the advantage of getting ahead in the count. You can really force hitters to expand their zone to protect. And when they're in that mode, getting them to go after a pitch they can't do much with becomes a lot easier.
Stepping in now, JT Realmuto, as the first pitch to him is in there for a called strike one.
Hey, this isn't exactly the way you'd like to draw it up. Not throwing a lot of first pitch strikes, but the bottom line is he's getting outs.
Realmuto behind with an 0-2 count now.
You got to cover the whole plate now after letting him steal two strikes on the inside half.
Now a fastball swung on and missed, and that is out number three. Phillies down in order. They trail this one 1-0. And stepping in, Brian Anderson. He'll look to light a spark under this lineup that hasn't found the scoreboard since back in the first inning.
Yeah, and for me, the story has been the starting pitching they face. It's been very difficult to rebound and, quite frankly, dominate after getting roughed up a bit in the first inning of a start. So I'll give him a lot of credit for what he's been able to do.
Now the pitch. And a strike called at the letters. Looked high to me, but it's nothing and one. A little quick on that swing, and he finds himself behind 0-2. Nothing and two count, and the pitch.
One ball, two strikes.
Hey, textbook waste pitch right there. Does he go elevated fastball again or something slow below the zone?
Rolled slowly down the third baseline, but this is a foul ball as the count holds steady at 1-2. Into the windup and the pitch. And he lays off a pitch outside as they draw even at 2-2. Hit in the air out to right. Harper has a read on it. One down. Next to stand in is Connor Scott, struck out in his last trip to the plate.
Yeah, and kind of shocked he got blown away with a fastball. You could tell he was late on that one. And we'll see if he tries to cheat to something this AB.
And if fastball's off the plate away, it's ball one. Swung on and lifted in the air to left center. Center fielder giving chase, and this is into the alley and ought to be good for extra bases.
Their own pitcher is absolutely dealing right now, so this is a big moment in this game. If his teammates can pick him up and drive him in now, that might be all they need to get the W here.
Into the box now, Eliezer Hernandez. As he'll take a look at a pitch too low, it's ball one. He's 0-for-1 thus far. The 1-0 is offered at and missed for the first strike.
Hey, that was a nasty pitch right there. Ton of rotation on that ball. You could almost see the red dot from up here. Nasty depth.
Pulls this one in the air out to left. McCutcheon is under it, and he makes the catch for the second out. And no tag at second. He'll head back there with two away now. Digging in next will be Starling Marte. It was a walk in his last trip. Looking to keep this a one-run game, the pitch.
There's a pitch we haven't seen in a while. It's going to be tough on the hitters if they have to incorporate that into their mindset.
And it's fouled away.
On 0-2 here, he doesn't have to give in with a great pitch to hit. He's got a base open, so he has to focus on making a good pitch right here.
And now here's a ball hit pretty well out toward right center field.
Paisley
will get there, and he puts it away to retire the side. One left for Miami, but they're on top 1-0. Welcome back for the bottom fifth. Here's Heidi Watney.
Matt, I had a chance to catch up with manager Girardi to commercial break about the Phillies offense, and he told me he's pretty unhappy with their discipline at the plate in this one. He said that they're playing into the pitcher's game plan today by expanding the strike zone way too often. Instead of swinging at pitches in the strike zone that they can do something with, they're often chasing at pitches out of the zone, which is resulting in a lot of their outs. Going forward, they have to start being more selective, guys.
All right, thanks, Heidi. Here's Andrew McCutcheon now. He leads off in the bottom of the fifth as they look to break through on the scoreboard for the first time in this one.
Yeah, no doubt about it. You can tell in between innings, the veterans in that dugout going up and down the line, trying to keep this lineup from getting super frustrated. They just have to find a way to piece it together, maybe pass the baton, get some wheels in motion, maybe get aggressive on the base paths if they can get somebody on.
Ball one to start the at-bat. The 1-0. It's laid off, but in there for strike one.
You can bet he wants that one back at the plate right now. That's a pitch you normally see a guy drive if he has the right approach going.
From the windup, the 1-1 pitch.
2-1.
Hey, throwing the ball great up into this point. Don't want to allow a leadoff walk. Needs to just focus in on his mechanics right here.
3-1 pitch is a slider, and he can't pull the trigger. It's 3-2 now.
Not much you're going to do with that pitch right there. You have to catch it out front before it even breaks, and even if you do that, it's a tough pitch to keep fair.
And here's the 3-2 from him. Oh, a fastball swung on and missed, and for the second time today, he's gone on strikes.
I'll tell you, he looks really dialed in on the bump right there. He's got a shutout going, and he really seems to have this lineup off balance. Even when he challenges them up in the zone, they don't have an answer for it.
So now to the plate, Didi Gregorius. As the changeup to him drops in there for the first strike. Comes into this at bat 0 for 1 in the ball game. Now the pitch. And he misses with it 1 and 1. And now a fastball, but he's able to hold off on it, and it's 2-1 now. And he fires a fastball now for a called strike two.
If he's able to locate that two-seamer down at the knees, he's going to get a ton of swing and miss and a ton of ground balls today.
Now here's one hit in the air to the right side. Birdie is over, and he tucks it away for the second out. Next, Adam Hinsley flied out in his first at bat, so it'll make him 0-1 so far. And the pitch.
Ball one.
Below the knees, one ball, no strikes.
Hey, this guy's got to be pretty proud of what he's done so far. It's never easy to pitch on the road, but to have this kind of outing in a ballpark that is notoriously known as being hitter friendly, it's been a treat to watch.
Bases are empty here with two men out. On the ground to the right side. And this will get through into right, and he's aboard with a single.
Hey, after that base knock right there, he's into double digits, D-Ro. That's a 10-game hitting streak. Oh, you're talking about double digits, Dan. Now it's getting firm. We're seeing the batting average go up. We're seeing the homers go up. We're seeing the RBIs go up. Everything is moving north.
At the plate now, Zach Wheeler, as he'll swing and miss at a first pitch slider at strike one. He's 0 for 1 after grounding out in his only trip to the plate so far. Now the 0-1. And this ball's heading for the seats down the right side as the count will move to 0-2 now. Fouled away. Hazley is off of first with two away. look out. Oh, that got him. And any time you hit the pitcher, you're asking for trouble.
Oh, boy. Pro pitchers belong to a closed fraternity, so you don't usually see that very often. And any time it does happen, folks start hanging on the top steps of the dugout. These things usually don't go unpunished.
Gene Segura standing in.
And he puts it on the ground to second.
And that's through into right field for a base hit. The throw home. And he will be tagged out at the plate. So it remains a one-run deficit here as the side is retired. Phillies leave a couple. It remains 1-0. John Birdie. As he'll watch a slider that runs out of the strike zone away for ball one. A hit and two at-bats for him at this point in the ballgame. Here's the pitch. Now here's a swing and a high pop-up drifting into shallow right field. There to take it is Gregorius for the first down. Ready now for the Marlins. Corey Dickerson. No hits in two trips to the plate for him in the ballgame. First pitch coming. Here it is. Boom. Trying to get there. On its way, the 0-1 pitch. Outside for a ball, 1-1.
Very impressive outing so far. His command has been spot on. Even when he misses his spot, it isn't out over the heart of the plate. He's throwing quality pitches.
The 1-1 home. Line drive to left. A dive, but it's off his glove.
Nothing fires me up more than watching a hitter take what a pitcher gives him. Pitches away, batter's able to keep his hands inside, not try and do too much, and just force feed a single.
In now, Jesus Aguilar, as he'll take a look at a sinker here, too low for ball one. 1-for-2 in the ball game thus far. The 1-0 delivery.
2-0.
Maybe a bit of an overthrow there, guys. May have let that front side open up a little early to try to hump up on a fastball and sailed on it.
The 2-0.
Hit side, ball three.
Miguel Rojas will be next. Yeah. That one's in there, 3-1. Hitters count all the way. Here it comes. Tried to crush that ball and now perhaps needs to shorten up with two strikes. Now the 3-2 pitch. Hit down the third baseline. There's one. Relay to first in time. And just like that, the side is retired. Marlins down quietly, but they're up 1-0. Jesus. And now, Alec Bohm. It's been an 0-for-2 effort for him to this point.
From third baseman, Alec Bohm.
Here's the first pitch to him. Swing and a miss, and he's behind 0-1.
I know it's cliche and it's tired at times, but a well-located fastball down at the knees is still the best pitch in the game.
Into the windup, here comes the 0-1. Ground ball sent back up the middle. He's got it. And there's one down now. So one gone now as we give you a look at where these two teams find themselves entering play in the National League's Eastern Division race. One out for the Phils in their half of the sixth, and that'll bring in a dangerous hitter indeed in the form of Bryce Harper. Infield in the overshift here, now the pitch. And he gets ahead 0-1.
This is why the manager pencils these guys in the middle of the order. Big spot, time for them to get back in this game with a couple quality ABs.
Harper behind with an 0-2 count now.
Wow, this guy has been on top of it today, pushing the throttle and pulling it when he needs to.
I got to count 1-2.
Inside, as that perhaps will back him off a bit, 1-2. Fastball, strike three called as he couldn't pull the trigger, and there are two away.
I think we're starting to see the frustration mount from this offense. It's been a pretty dominant performance on the mound, and these hitters have had no answer for anything he's throwing up there. That will wear on you if it lasts throughout most of the game like it has here.
Next to bat will be Rhys Hoskins as he lays off a fastball too low for ball one. He's 0 for 2 in the ballgame so far. Below the zone, a swing and a miss.
Ball, one strike.
Two out, nobody on. Two balls, one strike.
Hey, after those two breaking balls missed, you have to be sitting on a fastball right here.
The 2-1 home is laid off for ball number three.
Hey, he's had great command all day. Want to see how aggressive he is in the zone with a three-ball count.
Looking to fade his first walk. Here it comes. And this one misses for ball four. So the Phillies have got themselves a two-out base runner.
Well, you never want to issue a free pass if you can help it. But when a hitter like that digs in, you'd rather he's standing at first than driving a ball out of here and erasing your one-run lead.
Next to dig in, JT Realmuto. He went down on strikes in his last at-bat.
Yeah, he didn't put up much of a fight either, Matty. Gotta find a way. Can't go down three pitches. I don't care if you're staring at him or swinging at him. You have to find a way to make this pitcher work a little bit harder.
He's ready. Here's the first pitch. Swing, and he pops him up. And that'll get down for a base hit. So now they'll have two men in scoring position following the two-out double.
Wow, he must be living right because he gets absolutely jammed. Thought we were going to see the bat splinter, but instead, he muscled the ball to right for a double. Might get some heckles from his teammates, but no doubt, he'll take it.
So now to the plate, Andrew McCutchen tried to check it, and it's 0-1. 0 for 2 for him to this point. Comes set, the 0-1.
0-1.
Boy, the Phillies have been looking for some offense all game long. They've yet to find it. Let's hope they can find it pretty soon.
Hit out to a second. And that is in the center field as he comes through. It's a base hit. And the second run will score as well.
A
not hit all that hard to the roll. He muscled it out there for a two RBI base hit.
Yeah, I don't care, Dan. Long dart, off the end of the bat, jam sandwich, doesn't matter. Found himself some green grass and gets two ribbies.
Now the Marlins skipper's up out of the dugout on his way to the mound. And he's going to make a move, as that's going to be all for his starter this afternoon. He'll depart after 5 2/3, as it'll be up to the bullpen to keep his guys in the ballgame. Chris Russon takes over here with the runner at first and two gone in the inning. To the plate now, Didi Gregorius. As he'll take a look at ball one. 0 for 2 from him so far in this one. The 1-0. Swung on but fouled off to the left. Both teams with 6 hits so far. Fouled off again, and now he's in a 1-2 hole. Has a look, now the pitch.
Ball, that's out.
High fly ball out to straightaway center. Marte is under it. He handles it easily, and the inning is over. So it's 2 runs on 2 hits, no errors, and a runner left. 7th inning coming up. It's the Phillies 2 and the Marlins 1. Seventh inning ready to roll, and stepping in is the veteran shortstop, Miguel Rojas.
Down by one, I'm interested to see how they approach this as an offense, especially if they get someone on base early in the inning. Some teams, you know, they're going to try and manufacture that run, just trying to get that one run across. Others, they're going to look for one or two big swings to make it happen.
One ball, no strikes, the count. Now a good pitch around the knees, but it doesn't quite catch the bottom of the zone.
You'll hear me say this time after time up here in the booth. You fight so hard to get into these counts. 1-0, 2-0, 3-1. They don't happen often. This is a huge spot. Count leverage. Look for him to get loose on a fastball right here.
3-1 to the Marlins middle infielder.
Team's been struggling on offense. Let your D work for you right here. Pound the zone.
Lays off ball four. So now the potential tying run here is aboard late in the game.
Man, that's a tough one to swallow. You're hanging on to a slim lead, and the last thing you want to do is give up a leadoff walk. Seems like those are the ones that always come back to haunt you. So we'll see if that's the case here.
And Joe Girardi's going to get up off the dugout bench and confer at home plate. So we'll likely see a double switch here. Ranger Suarez will come on now, and he'll slide into the 7th spot in the lineup following the double switch. Ronald Torayans will also come on now, as he'll move into the pitcher's number 9 hold in the order here on that double switch. Up next from Miami, Jacob Stallings, 0 for 2 on the afternoon so far. First delivery to him, and they'll play for the tie here as he puts this one down. Throw goes to first here, so it works just as they drew it up, and now the possible tying run is in scoring position at second. So now to the plate, Brian Anderson, lifetime versus this pitcher. He's just 1 for 6. Now the first pitch. Hit back up the middle, and that is through into center field, a base hit. He's in there at the plate. And this ball game is tied here in the seventh.
You know, D-Row, in today's game, it's not easy scoring in the late innings, so that RBI base hit to tie things up, that comes at a really good time.
Yeah, I say it's not easy. They got 11 guys in the bullpen, and I don't think a guy throws under 97 miles an hour with sinking cut. That is unbelievable he's able to get that knock in that big spot.
Into the box now, Connor Scott, as he will take a fastball in there at the knees for strike one. A hit and two tries for him so far. That's in there, and he's deep in the hole now, 0-2.
He's had to be sitting out over that outer half of the plate. For him to take those first two pitches right there, finds himself 0-2, I'll be surprised if the pitcher doesn't go right back to that spot.
And a swing and a miss as they got him with the slider there, two away.
Boy, that's really disappointing for a guy that has wheels, right? All he wants to do is get on base and take advantage of the strength of his game, which is his speed. But with the strikeout right there, you can't get on first base if you strike out.
Jazz Chisholm will come on to pinch hit here in a big spot.
Number two, Jazz Chisholm.
He comes set. Here's the nothing and nothing pitch. And he's a guy looking to break out in a big way. Hasn't been getting the results he or his club have been hoping for. Set and the 1-0 pitch gets him out in front on a good changeup. Two out with the possible go ahead run at first. And this one runs a little too far in, ball two. Strike two as the fastball is let go. Chases out of the zone for strike three, and that's the third out of the inning. Just one hit in the inning, but it was a big one right here as it ties the ball game. Bottom of the seventh inning coming up. Get up and stretch, and we're deadlocked now at two apiece. Feel like I got hundreds of them. No love for me. Anthony Bass gets the call from the pen to take the ball for the home seventh.
Number 52. Anthony Beck.
Now to bat, Adam Hensley. Try and get something started in the home half of the seventh. First pitch on the way. And here's a fastball called for strike one. Marlins have some action in the bullpen now as a right-hander is up and throwing. Now the pitch.
After two great pitches, he has a lot of options right now. He could bounce something or go elevated fastball.
Nothing in two count and the pitch. And a good bite to that slider as he swings through it for the first out of the inning.
Well, we've seen some really good pitching from these guys in this one. The bullpen has looked sharp and it backed up a nice effort turned in by the starter. These days, pitching has become a full staff effort, and I've been impressed with the job these guys have done so far.
Ronald Torres is the next to bat, as he'll take a look at a slider here that misses for ball one. He's newly entered into the ball game, so this will be his first trip to the plate here in inning number seven. Here's the 1-0.
Ball two.
Two runs, six hits, and no errors on the ledger for the Phillies to this point. Daniel just watch the splitter here, 2-1. Hit on the ground to third. Throwing time at first for out number two. And that'll bring up Gene Segura. 2-for-3 with a double on his line so far. Now here's the pitch.
Counts 1-0.
The 1-0. Fouled off. Bases are empty here with two men out. On the screws to shortstop. Takes the mound as he's been called upon to pitch.
Number 31.
So here is Starling Marte. He'll have the first crack at it here as we start inning number 8. And now pitch on the way. On to the 8th now as the first pitch is a fastball that's looked at for ball one. Hot shot to third and handled for the first out.
The batter number 5, second baseman.
Next to hit is John Birdie. It was a flyout for him in his last trip. Now here's the first offering. Tough to do much with that one, a swing and a miss.
Hey, if I'm on the mound, I'm going even further out of zone on this next pitch.
Easy fly ball into shallow center field. In there, a base hit. The throw into second, but he'll be in there with a double.
And he obviously didn't let last night's hitless outing get to his head too much, because that's his second hit of the ball game. This one a double. I'm sure he's feeling a lot better about the way he's going right now.
At the plate now, Corey Dickerson. As the first pitch to him is taken low and away for ball one. He's got a hit in 3 at-bats to this point. Ready with the 1-0. Oh, much too tardy on the fastball. 1-1.
I don't blame the batter for pulling the trigger right there. Those fastballs light up your eyes, and you can occasionally do damage with them. But he wasn't able to catch up with that one.
And a dive, but he's back in there. The 1-1. Lofted in the air out toward right center. Harper is over to his right as he puts this one away. 2 down. Two gone now in the Miami 8th. And up next will be the power-hitting first baseman, Big Jesus Aguilar. A decent lead at second. Here's the pitch. Now a swing and a miss. Took something off that one, and it's strike one.
For most people, being down 0-1 would seem like a lot, but this guy is such a good hitter. He doesn't care going deep in the count. He's got runners on base. He has a game plan every time he comes to the plate. Let's see how this one plays out.
0-2, here it is. A swing and a miss as he chased with 2 strikes, and that will retire the side. Clearly fired up to work out of that jam. More to come on the show Sunday Baseball after this. go for the last half of the inning. And set to go is the third baseman, Alec Bohm. He's set. Here it comes. Ripped down the first baseline. This gets foul. It's 0-1. Now here's the pitch. And they go right after him here as he swings and misses. Strike two.
Hey, he's got excellent stuff working right now. Somebody has to make an adjustment. You're seeing a lot of late swings. No one's getting the front foot down. No one's getting the barrel to the baseball.
Swing and a miss on the fastball, and that's the first out.
If you've got a good fastball going and they're not handling, keep throwing it. Right there, three fastballs in a row. He gone.
Harper.
Next to dig in will be Bryce Harper. He'll take a look at a slider that can't make it back to the corner. It's ball one. He's hitless in three at-bats to this point. And that's into the corner, a foul ball and right. The 1-1. And he lays off a pitch outside as they draw even at 2-2. Bases are empty, one man out. Pulled toward right center field. Marte is there as he had to travel the ways, but he makes the catch deep in the alley for the second out.
Number 17.
And that one will be the cleanup spot for the Phillies. Rhys Hoskins. No hits to this point. He's ready. Here's the first pitch.
This guy uses that two-seamer to set up his other pitches. Two-seamer in, breaking ball away.
Two out, nobody on. Plays off again, and it's 2-0.
Well, this is a spot you'd like to be in. 2-0, good hitter. He's going to turn it loose right here.
The 2-0.
Ball, that's out.
Now with the bases empty, I think he needs to be careful not to just groove one here just because it's 3-0. He's a guy that could ambush you and lose one over the wall.
Ready with the 3-0. And he lays off ball four. Now the potential go-ahead run is on base here. So that's the second walk he's worked in this one.
Yeah, and that seems to be a popular approach when this guy steps in. He can really hurt you with one swing. So I think the idea is mostly not to let this one guy beat you, Matt.
Now time is called, and we'll have a pinch runner at first. And that'll be a wise decision as he's the potential go-ahead run. Standing in now, JT Realmuto, chopped weakly to the right. So far, 2-for-3 in this one. Come set, the 0-1.
0-2.
That's inside and low. It's a ball and two strikes. And a fastball swung on, missed, and the side is retired. Phillies strand one. Score remains 2-2. Brad Miller is going to come on as a defensive replacement now as he takes over at first base.
Number 13.
New inning set to get underway, and stepping up as the shortstop, Miguel Rojas.
Leading off for the Marlins, the shortstop, Miguel.
Wheels and deals. Here's the first pitch. Swing and a liner. On a base hit. So a great start to the ninth as the possible go-ahead run is aboard to kick off the inning.
The bat. The catcher.
Stepping in now, Jacob Stallings. This will show bunt, but pull it back for ball one. Go ahead run at first, nobody out. The 1-0. Trying to get that go ahead run to scoring position now as he puts this one down. Throw is going to go on to first, so a perfect sacrifice there is now the go ahead run moves into scoring position here. Big at bat now, and here is Brian Anderson. And a chance they walk him here to set up a double play that would keep the game tied. Here's the first pitch. Looked like the fastball got away from him there. Go ahead runs in scoring position here with one away. And that's in there for his strike, one and one. And did he go around? No, he did not. Ball two. Lifted in the air toward the line and right. Harper giving chase. He makes the catch, and tagging is the runner from second. And he's up to third safely now with two gone in the inning. Now it'll be Connor Scott, and he bats in a big spot here. Go ahead run at third, two men out. Here's the first pitch.
One ball, one strike.
Go ahead runs in scoring position here with two down. To short. Segura has it. Throw to first with time to spare, and the side is retired. Marlins lead one. Score remains deadlocked at 2-2. Now we're going to have a conference at the home plate area, so it would appear that we'll see a double switch here. Adam Simber will come on to pitch now as he'll move into the eighth spot in the lineup on the double switch here. Adam Duvall is into the ball game as well as he'll slide into the pitcher's spot, hitting ninth now on the double switch.
The left fielder, Andrew.
Ready to deliver. Here comes the first pitch. Andrew McCutchen is in to start things off as he looks at a ball to start the inning, 1-0. Now action in the bullpen as their closer starts to get loose out there. A ball and no strikes. Here it is. And he won't bite at that one either. It's 2-0.
I don't mind him trying to pitch him backwards right there with those two early count sliders, but now he finds himself in a situation where he's going to have to come fastball.
Now a swing, and here's an immediate chance for the new guy as this is in the air to right. Duvall is over near the stands as he makes the catch for the first down. Matt
Your
Joyce will get the call here as he'll hit for the pitcher.
Number seven. Matt.
Ready to deal. Here comes the first pitch. Hey. Ready with the nothing and one pitch. And a check swing here as he couldn't help himself, and it's ruled strike two. One out, nobody on. Here's a chopper to first. And he'll take it to the bag himself for the out. Now with the plate is Adam Hensley. He's working on a 1-for-3 thus far. First pitch on its way. Comes set. The 0-1. Now a ball rolled softly to second. Scooped up. Throw over to Aguilar at first. He'll take care of him to end the inning. Three up, three down for Philadelphia. And this game is still tied at 2-2. Archie Bradley takes the mound as he'll be the first man to pitch here in extra innings. Garrett Cooper is up off the bench to pinch hit here, so we'll see what he can do to begin the extra frame. Here's the first pitch. Fly ball out to straightaway right. Harper has a read on it. Makes the play. One away. Next up is Starling Marte. And a chance they walk him here to set up a double play that will keep the game tied. Here's the first pitch. A couple of righties starting to loosen now in the bullpen. The 1-0. 1-1 the count now. The 1-1 pitch. One ball and two strikes to count.
I mean, he's coming right after him, Matty. Three fastballs in a row.
High in the air out to center field. Hensley is there now, and he has it, two gone. Next up, John Birdie. He's doubled and singled in four at-bats in this contest. Here's the first pitch. In the dirt. Throw goes to third. The tag's there, and he's out trying to steal third. Great throw. Nothing doing for the Marlins. Score remains 2-2. Digging in now for Philadelphia, Ronald Torres. And he's got a chance to bring in the winning run. The question is whether they'll even pitch to him. Here's the first pitch.
This has to be a productive at-bat right here. I know you want to drive the run in and get the RBI, but you have to find a way, bare minimum, to move this runner over to third.
Lays off the sinker here, a ball and a strike. Some action out in the bullpen. Couple of right-handers starting to loosen up. Lofted in the air out toward right center. Long run for the right fielder. He's not going to get to it, so the leadoff guy is aboard with a base hit.
Matty, it's hard to say right here. I got to believe they dove into the scouting reports on every outfield arm. He did not take an aggressive pass coming around third base bag right there, so I just think the third base coach had to hold it.
Scott Kingery will be summoned now to be the pinch runner. At the plate, Gene Segura has the first pitch to him, runs a bit inside for ball one. And he has a great opportunity to win it here. Winning run at third base, nobody out. Now it's 2-0.
Hey, time to start making some quality pitches. He finds himself in a tough spot behind an account with guys on base.
2-0. Oh, on the ground is short. Could this be two? A second for one to Aguilar for the double play.
Doesn't come much easier than that. Taylor made 6-4-3 double play and an easy one to turn.
Now into the box, Alec Bohm. He's gone hitless to this point.
Not a great game up to this point, but none of that would matter if he could come through right here. A chance to be the hero.
Here's the first pitch.
Ball one, no strike.
And ooh, looked like a definite pitcher's pitch there on the inside, 1-1. Ah, gets him to swing at a pitch now, down and out of the zone, 1-2. And he strikes him out to retire the side, so we'll play at least one more. A big-time strikeout and some raw emotion as he gets out of the jam. 10 innings in the books, on to the 11th, still tied. Scott Kingery will stay in the ballgame now as he comes on to play second here.
Now playing second base, number 4, Scott Kingery.
11th inning set to get underway, and that'll bring in the second baseman, John Birdie. Here's the first pitch. Now a 58-foot curveball that misses for a ball. Top, it's 2-0.
Well, you see this a lot. A guy comes out of the bullpen throwing bullets, but he has a tough time finding the zone. Trust me, velocity is a great weapon if the hitters are tempted to swing.
Now the 2-1.
Ball three.
Corey Dickerson will be next. The 3-1 pitch. 3-2, full count. Again, another foul ball. Ready with another two-strike offering. Rounded weakly toward third. Gonna be a tough play on the first. And how important is it to keep this guy off base in a tie ball game? One away. Big spot here. And it'll be Corey Dickerson. Oh, they might pitch around him here with a couple of bases empty. Here's the first pitch.
Well, this is a strikeout situation, but it's also a ground ball situation. I expect we'll see a lot of pitches down in the zone trying to prevent the hitter from getting the ball up in the air.
And a pitch out. Perhaps they thought the squeeze would be on. The 1-1 pitch. And look out as that one ran in and got him.
Well, when you hear people talk about the unwritten rules of baseball, I think we just saw a perfect example of that. You hit one of mine, and I'm going to hit one of yours. Always been that way and probably always will be, even though they've tried to crack down on that kind of stuff recently.
So here's the cleanup hitter for Miami, Jesus Aguilar. And clearly this is a critical moment in this ball game. Go-ahead run at third with one away. Here's the first pitch.
Especially after drilling the last guy up at the plate, that's just a great job to get your mechanics back onto you and establish yourself back in the strike zone.
Runners are at the corners with one man out. 1-1 now the count to the Marlins first baseman.
Hey, he threw that pitch with a purpose to get a double play. Good job to let it go by, though, as a hitter.
And a knuckle curve missed that time. 2-1.
Hey, lots of guys get too aggressive in a spot like this, but he's done a nice job of gaining some count leverage. Look for him to put the ball in play hard.
Now the 2-1. Now a fly ball towards foul territory. Might be smart to let this drop, and it's a foul ball. But a foul ball as it holds it 2-2. Runners are at first and third, one away. Swing and a miss. He struck him out. And a big out there as the go-ahead run stays at third with two gone now.
That was a good job there of using the batter's aggressiveness against him. He was putting up a good fight and fouling a lot of balls off. So as a pitcher, it's a great idea to expand the zone even more and make the hitter really chase after something that's even hard to foul off.
In now, Miguel Rojas. He'll pop this one foul off to the left and out of play. He's got a hit in three at-bats to this point. He's set. The 0-1. In the dirt and blocked behind the plate. Good job to corral this quickly as the runners hold on. The 1-1. Check swing here as he couldn't help himself, and it's ruled strike two. Runners at the corners, two men out. Shin high, that's taken for a ball. Grounder down the line at third. Fielded cleanly, and the inning will end as they're unable to cash in with two outs. Marlins strand a pair. Score remains deadlocked at 2-2. Dylan Floro takes over now to start the home 11th, and he's looking to get this one to the visiting 12th.
Dylan Floro.
Chance to walk it off, and now here is Bryce Harper. The winning run stands at second base. Here's the first pitch. And he takes ball one. The 1-0. Now an off-speed pitch that nearly ran in and got him.
Not even close with the 1-0. He needs to get back in his zone, but be careful. Work the quadrants.
Drives it to deep right field. But this is taken in on the warning track as the runner will tag from second. And he'll make it up to third safely here with one away. Next will be the cleanup hitter, Brad Miller, for his career in this matchup. He's 2-for-3. Here's the first pitch. Possibly winning run just 90 feet away here. One away. And a good heater as he just watches this baby, a ball and a strike.
This is a situation where you're going strictly for the strikeout. Infield in, and from the offensive standpoint, you're just trying to create hard contact and get it by that infield.
Two balls and a strike now. Now the 2-1. To 2-2 now.
Well, he's hoping to be a hero and drive in the winning run, but that swing tells me he's a little too amped up. You don't chase a pitch that badly if you're playing within yourself.
And he fouls this one off. Possible winning run just 90 feet away here. One away. third. Right to him on to first when there were two down. Up next, JT Realmuto. Oh, they might pitch around him here with a couple of bases empty. Here's the first pitch. Now a slider, and he gets ahead of him here 0-1.
Hey, great job pounding the zone, strike one. When you got a great hitter in the box, you got to get ahead. Count leverage is a must.
Big spot here. Possible winning run at third. Two down. Pitch is popped up. Rojas over to his left on to first, and that'll mean a 12th inning is in order as this inning is over. One left for Philadelphia, and this game is still tied at 2-2. Now the skipper's on his way out toward the home plate area, and I believe that means we're going to have a double switch here. Brandon Kinsler gets the ball as he'll take over to start this 12th inning. On to the 12th frame in this one, and now it'll be the catcher, Jacob Stallings. Here's the first pitch. The 0-1.
1-1.
Now some action in the Phillies bullpen as a right-hander begins to crank it up out there. The 1-1 pitch. Line to the right side. And that will get through into right. So there's your possible go-ahead run on base to lead off the inning.
Hey, you know what? You could slowly start to see that batter leak out over the plate. That was three straight pitches on the outer half, and he was able to dive out there and get an opposite field single. Nice job.
Jorge Alfaro will come on now and pinch run here.
Number 38, Jorge Alfaro.
Into the box, Brian Anderson. Runners breaking for the plate. And a late squeeze attempt, and it looks like it's going to work. So they get the out at first, but the run will score on the suicide squeeze. So a gutsy call there, as that takes some serious stones to call the suicide squeeze this late in the game, but the go-ahead run comes in to score. Chad Waller will grab a bat and hit for the pitcher here.
Number 17, Chad Waller.
First offering on its way. Bounce towards the second baseman. Kingery's there, and there's out number two. And that'll bring in Garrett Cooper. Lifetime against Brandon Kinsler. Just a couple of matchups, no hits and two at-bats. Trying to keep the deficit right where it is, the pitch. First pitch is a slider down low. It's 1-0. To 2-0 now as he hits with a runner at third and two away. 3-0 now.
Well, he really needs to make this guy swing the bat right here. He's not the type of hitter you want to dance around with.
Alfaro at third with two away. And there's a strike as he'll try to work his way back. It's 3-1. And this ball's pretty well struck high and deep to left field. He lays out for it, but he can't pull it in. And now the runner from third scores to give them a very important insurance run.
Dan, that's a huge insurance run right there. Has to feel good as a hitter right there to not only get a ribby knock, but to give your team a little bit of breathing.
It does, and it makes your pitcher go out there with a little bit more free and easy frame of mind instead of going into a one-run game where every pitch is so important. You're one pitch away from a solo tying the game up. That's not the case now.
Sam Coonrod, come on now and make his 55th appearance of the year. Starling Marte stands in again as they're back to the top of the order. He jump-started the game with a leadoff home run. Ready to deliver. Here comes the first pitch.
Ball one, no strike.
Runner in scoring position at second with two down. Swing and a ball hit high in the air, deep down the left field line. This has plenty of carry. And what an effort on the running play to end the inning. So it's two runs on two hits, no errors, and a runner left. And now we'll see if what's left of this crowd can rally their troops. Bottom of the 12th inning coming up. It's the Marlins 4 and the Phillies 2. Jorge Alfaro will stay in the ballgame as he'll likely do the catching from here out.
Number 38, Jorge Alfaro.
Roberto Osuna enters from the pen now as they've saved their closer until this deep into extra innings. The 12th inning now. Standing in is the veteran outfielder, Andrew McCutchen.
Listen, it's not easy coming back off of closers, but this guy hasn't been super dependable so far this season, and he's blown several saves up to this point.
Here's a fly ball, well hit. Looking up is Dickerson. That one is out of here. This game is tied. Two-run homer down the line in left, and we are tied again.
Big time at bat right there. Team trailing, and he ties it up with a bomb. Interested to see how this one finishes out.
To the plate now, Andrew Knapp. As the first pitch misses to him, it's ball one. The average right at 280 coming in. No home runs as of yet, and a couple RBIs. That's inside. 2-0.
Pretty good pitch right there. Fastball in off the plate. One of the things you want to do as a pitcher, try to stand those hitters up.
The 2-0 on the way. Now a drive to right field. This could do it. Game over. Walk-off home run. A solo shot here to straightaway right field. And with one swing of the bat, this ball game is over.
when you get into extra innings, you're always looking for that one guy to step up and be that hero. And this guy was the hero tonight. What does he do? Steps up with a walk-off home run to end this thing in extras.
Show.com.
Yeah. Coming easy to me, do that in one take. Yeah.